And welcome back. We are at the burial isle. The end game is swiftly approaching. Ready for a whole bunch of undeads, and I'm sure we're gonna find more. It's like a little path over here. Spring berries. This is pretty interesting looking, isn't it? A ruined structure of some kind. Can't go that way. These are all... Are these gravestones? Headstones? They're really big. What's going on over here? People tied up, or ashes of people that were tied up? I don't want to be heading for the tippy top yet. Well, it just leads up to there anyway. How do I get to that? 1710 copper. Grotto of Echoes. Alright, let's check out the Grotto of Echoes. We're getting 150 XP for just finding these places. A lot more than I believe it was 60 before. It's the Grotto of Echoes. 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 Something over there. Oh.
Now this I haven't seen before.
A log? Oh good. Because we're down one. Camping supply. Here's a scroll of Wall of Flame. To go with my other flamey scrolls. And a potion of major recovery. Just take that. Okay. Boy, butterflies and such. That's it? That's it for the Grotto of Echoes? Or maybe this is more of it here. No, apparently that's it. Okay. Oh, we got something here. I hate when they do that. So weird. It's like Theodos is absorbing them. I'm not sure if that's good or bad. Whatever it is, it's definitely weird. Oh, they all built camp there. Oh, who's this? A shade? Okay, so while we're having a vision, we're gonna fight this thing. Can you also attack, Kanna? Kanna. The way we're all selected like that, I kind of meant for us all to attack.
Following your lead.
You disturbed our vision.
Yours.
Hmm.
How dare you? Oh, I didn't add that to. Oh, I did. Okay.
Yeah.
I shall be discreet.
It cut that out, will ya? How are we sneaking up on anybody with that sound? This one. I can't, yeah. I can't do that without injuring us. Chain lightning. Boom.
Lavaru, beyond.
It didn't like that much, did you? Both injured. Yeah, I get the feeling we're not really doing anything. He's turning towards it for the first time. Kill these things! Are attacking it, right? See? If we just attack them, we can destroy them. Palagina!
That's not very helpful.
I'm ready.
Palagina's freaking out! Oh god. Alright, let's rest. Stop your crap. Oh my god, we're still doing it.
Eh?
I shall be quiet as a calm sea. Which is not very quiet.
Alright, so I guess there's nothing else to see from that vision we had, because it was interrupted by baddies. Stairs up, we haven't gone that way yet. Go this way. What's this? Oh, a specter? Where? Where is it? Oh. Nice. Badly injured already. I like it.
lava room, the on seek.
There's two of them, right? Not bad at all.
Let's see what lies this way.
Got it.
It's another ghostly thing. Another potion of major recovery and 355 copper. Oh, I missed someone down here. Oh, have we been there yet? Yeah. Last blade of the White Forge. Unique one-handed sword. Exceptional weapon, which means plus 8 accuracy and plus 3% damage, plus 20% attack speed. The famed White Forge of Durgan's Battery produced some of the greatest weapons and pieces of armor known in the Eastern Reach. The White Forge's dwarven smiths carefully guarded the secret techniques they used to craft Durgan steel, legendary for its strength, flexibility, and ability to hold sharp edge. When Durgan's Battery was overrun by an unknown force, the fires of the White Forge went dark, and the secrets of Durgan steel died with its smiths. The owner of this sword was an Orlin from Twin Elms who claimed he found the naked blade near the skeleton of a dwarf in the foothills near Stalwart. Many were skeptical of his claims that it was a Durgan steel blade, but it bore the maker's mark of the White Forge. The Orlin had artisans from the Fisher Crane tribe create a guard, grip, and pommel to dress the blade, resulting in its unusual appearance. The proud owner's luck did not last long. He went missing somewhere near Elmshore shortly after receiving his finished sword. Many locals believed that he had been killed for his prize, but neither he nor his weapon were ever seen again. Until now. And I guess that's him. Alright, so he's got a cat's claw. These two are using two-handed swords, so compare. We might use this just because it's faster. Wait. One has a 3 damage reduction bypass, and this one has a 20% attack speed. Make it an undead destroying thing. Since we're fighting them now, and I'm sure we'll find undead more often, seems a pretty popular thing to fight. Okay. So we'll be using the last blade of the White Forge for a dare. Ready to kick some spirit butt. Let's head to these little wisps of soul or something or whatever the hell this is. She's absorbing them. Look, you know that? You notice that? When we go downstairs, we do it quicker. I like that. Because we're heading down, right? And does it work for going up, too? Yeah, we do go faster going up, too. Okay, never mind. Still interesting. I feel. Ooh. Two pogras. Ogres. Kill damage. And a men program. They're very happy. They're happy to see us. Kill the pogra first. Get out of the way. Integration on the men program.
Following your lead.
Did it work? Did we cast it? She's getting hit by stuff. Huh. Additional effects for 20.3 seconds. Oh, there's a rain blight now. Pillar of Holy Fire. Boom. That takes care of that. And that. What was that? Oh, spreading plague.
Be cautious.
Be
constant.
Plague on us. That's annoying. What's this? Is that something that... We don't seem to be able to know which way to go anymore. They're just turning into idiots. A blocked passage. Oh. Let's observe the block. Oh, that blocked passage. Okay. You venture through a doorway into an underground tunnel. A staircase coils upwards, leading to a dim passage. I thought it was blocked. Oh. On the upper level, light filters through the collapsed ceiling. A wall of piled stones and rubble blocks the way ahead. Pull the rubble loose. The rocks are heavy and appear to be wedged tightly together. Send a dare. Yeah, send a loth. Hmm. Adair, he is in tugs, but cannot move the rubble. How about Kana? Same. Clear the rubble with a pry bar. You wedge your pry bar against a large stone and put all your weight into it. Your efforts dislodge the boulder and it rolls free with a heavy groan. Other slabs and chunks of debris begin to break away. The massive pile creaks and rumbles, threatening to loose 1,000 pounds of stone around you. That's not good. As the debris tumbles down, you lunge through the narrowing gap. However, Durance isn't fast enough and disappears behind the falling rocks. What? Okay, Durance emerges from a cloud of dust, hunched over and cradling tender ribs. Light breaks into the tunnel up ahead, glowing brighter as you continue. Soon the passage ends, opening up high on the cliffside of the burial isle. Oh boy.
Eyes open.
Yeah.
Let's go!
Yeah, that's a way to sneak. Yell, let's go. Oh, this is gonna be tough. Tough, tough. Two Shangri-La freaking things. I'm gonna have to rest again after this. I got something to look at after we're done here. So. Let's try a wall of force. Yikes. Fireball. Barely injured. What is she? She's paralyzed. Okay. Suppress affliction.
What?
Where is she? She's still paralyzed. You cast it and we're still paralyzed? Do it again. He's paralyzed. Okay, he did it now. Just gonna keep healing that Aeloth. Oh, he's still working on that spell. Is this Theodos? Yeah, hit that. Oh no, don't. That's a person. Hit the shadows near death. Where is she? I can't even see. Durance, Aeloth, Theodos, Adair. I don't even know where Palagina is. Just keep fighting, Palagina. I can't find you. There we go. Durance. Where the hell is she? See her. More fireballs. He still has four. Aren't we using them up? Oh, there we go. He's almost out. Theodos, keep hitting. Well, there's Palagina. Okay. Hit that. There. Hit that. Three left. Ooh, the Shangri-La thing is almost dead. I guess everyone hit this one. Alright, everyone hit this.
All is spelled and still couldn't
what's his name's out? Aeloth. Supposedly we've only got this stuff. Yep. Keep crying.
Eyes are peeled.
What does this poor body hold? Ah, camping supplies. He's being nice to us. Glamfellen stalking boots. We've already found a pair of those. That's the way back down through that passage. And then this. What? The towering stone creature is cold and slimy with fungal growth. Its horns look sharp enough to saw through lumber. We still haven't looked up there. Well, this just ends. But we've been right down there. Can't go that way. Ooh, I want that though. Thank you muchly. A balloon, 2 bloodstones, and 85 gold. A will-o-wisp. All those things are easy. Of course, there might be other things, like another will-o-wisp, perhaps? Kinda, hurry up, will ya?
Yes.
Oh my god, we forgot about Aelon. I needed to rest. Crap. My bad, I messed that one up.
Following your
No good. Yeah, not acceptable. Yeah, he's like dead. Alright. Sorry to disappoint you guys. I'm not gonna continue like this with Aelon, Dad. I messed that one up. I messed that one up big time. So I'm going to basically play this whole episode over again since I haven't saved. No, I haven't saved since the beginning, so. Thanks for watching. See you next time. See you around this area again. I'll go the same way and we'll see with Aelon not dead and we'll see what's what. Thanks for watching and endure. In enduring, grow strong.